Hello, my name is Anthony Hall, and in this tutorial we're going to be creating a jam donut. So I've got a couple here to show you what I mean, like so. So let's get straight into it. So on a new layer, I'm going to create, use the foroid tool. This tool, I'm not sure if it's in versions going back past 2018. I think it was added in 2018. I could be wrong, but I'm not sure if there's any similar tools. I think that there's a couple in here, super quadric tool, that might do similar things, so you'll have to play around with it really. But I'm in 2020, so when it opens up the tool with a numerical, you get the generic shape, which is actually the shape we really want. We can go with that. I'm not going to change it. You can if you want. So you've got like the radius tool. You've got how many segments you kind of want around and in and around and stuff. You've got the height. You've got the start angle as well. And the positioning and so on and so forth. But I think what we'll do is we'll just stick with what we've got. Okay, so let's shut that down. So let's give this a name. Let's go donut for the layer, and then Q on my keyboard. Let's give it a kind of, well, it's like a beigey kind of wheaty colour. So that'll do. It's not a spot on, but it'll do. So I've got that. That's the next bit. Next we want icing. So for the icing, I'm just going to, while I'm on my polygon tool, I'm going to right mouse click and lasso in the back view to select these top polygons, like so. Now you can select another row if you want your icing to come further down. I'm just going to stick with this. What I'm going to do then is I'm going to go to edit, copy, go in a new layer, and then edit, paste. So we've got this ready to use as the icing. Now currently it's all a bit perfect, so is in fact the background. If we look at the actual donut and then we look at the icing, I know donuts don't really come out of that perfect. They probably taste perfect, but they don't come out that perfect. So there's a couple of things we could do. Let's just select them both, obviously the icing's inside, and let's manipulate them a little bit. So what I'm going to do, I did an ice cream tutorial and I use this fractal ice, but what I'm going to do this time is you're going to go to modify and use a tool called jitter. Now with the jitter there's different options, but I'm going to use the Gaussian option, and we're going to put in 50 mil in each, because currently I'm working on 500 mil per square for my actual grid. But what I want to do is I want to kind of blur the polygons, which is basically give it a bit of noise. So if I press OK, and you get this. So if I tab the key on the keyboard, if I go to the actual donut and then the icing, like so. So it's not perfect, but I don't want it to be too manipulated. I just want it to be a little bit so you can tell it's not perfect. So with the actual icing, let's give it some thickness. So the thicken tool, let's bring it up like so. Let's have a look. So we've got it on top. Now it depends how thick you want the icing, it's completely up to you. Let's give it a, just put ice like so, and let's give it a, just call it ice and make it a, I don't know, a pink or something like that, like a pinky color. Like so. So what we've got is the actual representation of the icing on top. I mean, again, it's up to you if you wanted to manipulate it and make it even more. You could come in here and you could select like points and start like manipulating bits around the side and stuff if you want to not make it a bit more, not so uniformed. So all I'm doing is selecting points and just like manipulating and pulling them and stuff. So you can do stuff like that. You can also put the actual donut in the background. Go to modify, there's a tool called magnet. So if you right mouse click, not left, right, and draw out an area of influence in the side and the top, and then move this to where you want it to influence, then left click, it will manipulate, just pull it around so you can see, it will manipulate what's inside that area. So you can kind of, oh, okay, let's move it, say there, and then manipulate it a little bit. So you can actually go around and manipulate the icing if you want in that way. Okay, but I'm just going to stick with what I want so I can zip through this. So next, what I want to do is just simply add some sprinkles on top. So we're going a new layer. Now in the ice cream tutorial I did, I just simply came in, went into capsule, numerical, and then I came up with the actual size by manipulating this to whatever size I kind of wanted. And again, that's what you've got to do. You've just got to come in and decide on how big you want these sprinkles to be and what kind of sprinkles. And again, I'm just using something like this. Just reduce some of the segments. Again, something like that. So let me just zoom out and decide on. Okay, something like that I'll do for the time being. So I've got one, let's just call it one. And for this one, I'm just going to give it a service name and we'll just call it white. So we'll have some white sprinkles. So I could do multiple sprinkles if I wanted, but I'm just going to have some white ones. And then what I'm going to do is I'm just going to use a move tool just to move it up, still being centered, just so I've got a little bit underneath, so this bit here will be embedded into the icing. So let's go to the icing. Let's put the sprinkle in the background. Go to modify, place mesh, numerical. Let's just reset everything. 0 and 0. And then let's just click populate. Now the problem is with this, it's gonna put an actual one of the sprinkles on every single point, which is way, way too perfect. Imagine working in a factory and you have to go and make it like this. So again, it's not amazing. Some of them are floating around and it's just not quite going right. The other option, what you could do is you could again, you could come in with the place mesh and you could click and place them where you want them to be, do you know what I mean, and rotate them and stuff and go around and place them yourself. But again, a bit time consuming, definitely don't want to have to do that. So what else can we do? So what I'm going to do, I'm going to win a new layer. Let's put the icing in the background. So what I want to do is make some random points that I can use a heat shrink to suck into the icing. So it's a lot more random than just adding them to the actual points. So to do that, we go to create. If we go down to where it says points here, there's an option that says spray points. So press on that and bring up numerical. What we're going to do is we're going to tell it to spray 2 points at about 0.5 millimeters away from each other. Okay, so literally going to click and drag around in a circle like so to there. Let's just say that. Okay, so I'll shut it down, press the space bar, then I'm going to use the move tool. Let's bring it up in the air. So I've got all these random points like so. Yep, so why it's like this, I'm going to go to modify, heat shrink, numerical. Now it might be on normals, switch the actual mode to Y and then suck down. And what it'll do, it'll grab as many as it can in that area and it will place it randomly points on top of the icing. So once we've done that, shut it down, drop the tool, While you're on points, use the right mouse click and let's just lasso around all these ones we don't want and then delete on your keyboard. Let's just check, I ain't got any. That's okay, but what I have got is I've got lots of random points on top of, as you can see, on top of the actual icing. So what we're going to do is let's put the actual donut in the background. Let's go to multiply, place mesh, numerical. Let's just try it that way now. Okay, they're all facing the same way out, so that's not great. So let's undo that. Let's tell it to have a random, let's say 45, and then let's say 45 again. Let's try it, and maybe a 5% size variation. Let's try it again. It's a bit better, so they're all over the shop. Drop the selection. Let's bring up the icing and the donut. And then what we've got is we've got our actual, it's probably not enough, I would say, which is not the end of the world. We've got it more random on top. I mean, if we go into the surface editor, I've got them as white, but I can't remember. I think they're more of a light pink, aren't they, on the, that they put on. Like so. And also, they're on their own layer, so again, you can manipulate them if you think they want to be brought down a little bit, you can, and so on. You can even, if I copy Command-C, Command-V, and have another load here, I suppose you could just in the center rotate it, so you've got like twice as many, but they're very random. Like so. So yeah, I've zipped through this quite quickly. Hopefully you've understood it. I try and do them as quickly as I can. Usually I babble on for about 20 minutes though, so this one's not bad at 11, 12 minutes. But again, I'm doing it quite quickly. If I was doing it for a client or anything, I'd be taking my time a lot more and playing around. But hopefully this introduces you to the tools I'm using and gets you to have a play around with the stuff I'm doing. So thanks for listening. Look out for my other tutorials. Please share, subscribe, and check out my Lightwave Salvation Facebook group. See you next time.